Dr. Connie Webster, Associate Provost for Academic Programs and Professor in the Department of Nursing and Allied Health at the University of the District of Columbia, and your host for Health Matters. Our purpose is to assist you in managing your health care by providing you balanced information and resources to help you make knowledgeable choices about your health. On this edition of Health Matters, our topic is healthy babies.
I like to use a quote from Abraham Lincoln. The quote is that no man stands so tall as when he stoops to help a child. Healthy Babies has been standing tall for over 25 years, ensuring that babies are born healthy. Dakota's family had some challenges. Her mother was involved with a man who had sexually abused Dakota for years. So Dakota eventually left that home and started living in her car and prostituting in order to make money. And she thought that prostitution was that was it, that was gonna be her life. Her pregnancy, and of course coming into the agency, changed that. The transitional house is something that we started 2 years ago because too many of the girls were homeless, like Dakota, and I was asking the board to give us the money to put them in hotels because the shelter systems were too full. So while we do home visiting, while home visiting is one of the services that we offer, we're also able to service the girls that are homeless and transients. And Dakota, you know, while she was with us, her baby, of course, Eternity, was born healthy. Eternity's doing beautifully. Dakota got her GED while she was there. She got housing, so she's no longer homeless. And she got into CCDC of UDC. And it's not just about reversing infant mortality. It's definitely about empowerment and changing the direction of that young mother's life.
And joining me for this discussion about healthy babies is Regine Ellie. Ms. Ellie is Executive Director of the Healthy Babies Project, INC, and with her, Nadira Harper, a mother in the Healthy Babies Project program, and Ms. Jasmine Brazier, Coordinator of Youth Services with Healthy Babies Project, INC. Ladies, Ms. Brazier, welcome to Health Matters.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, wow. This is a treat for me and for Health Matters because we almost always are talking about older or midlife people when we're talking about Health Matters, and we're always talking about cure and chronic diseases. So this is such a pleasant change to know that we can talk about new life in two ways. New life for the people that you're bringing into the world, and the fact that such a wonderful organization is available for teens and women at risk to provide them a new life.
Yes.
And having said that, Ms. Ellie, I'm gonna start with you because I know there are many people out there that are not that familiar with your nonprofit organization. Tell the viewers all they need to know about you today.
I'm going to use a quote, and the quote's from Abraham Lincoln, where Abraham Lincoln states that no man stands so tall as when he stoops to help a child.
I saw that.
Healthy Babies has been standing tall for over 25 years, ensuring that babies are born healthy, mm-hmm. ensuring that women have access to health care, ensuring that teens don't have to sell their bodies in order to survive, ensuring that teen moms have the choice to go on to finish high school and go on to education, realizing that just because they've had this baby, that isn't the end of their lives.
Yes.
It's a moment in their lives,
yes.
and they can still go on and move forward.
Yes.
Ensuring that these moms are tied into, as well as the dads, services to help them as well to move forward and change the whole trajectory of their lives. And so just because your mom was an addict doesn't mean that you're going to be an addict, doesn't mean that your child is going to be an addict.
Mm-hmm.
But just to give a little bit of history, Healthy Babies was founded in 1990.
Okay.
And when it was established, it was to combat infant mortality in wards 5 and 6. And at that time in 1990 was the crack epidemic in the district. And
right.
the infant mortality rate wasn't high overall and all over the district, but in wards 5 and 6 it was 33
per thousand live births. And so during that time period from 1990 to around 2009, we served women of childbearing age. But with the city, you've got a lot of funding, you know, struggles. And so, and I'm a New Yorker, so I talk a lot with my hands.
That's okay.
But we have a lot of funding struggles, and so funding changed. Mm-hmm. And so there was a lot of influx of teens, and teens is my passion.
Right.
I love to see teens make changes, positive changes in their lives, finishing high school, going on to college. And so we changed the focus to just focus on the pregnant teen population. And that reason is what I stated before. You can work with the teen moms to change that trajectory. Just because your mom didn't finish high school and got pregnant as a teen doesn't mean that that's the same statistic for you. And that's something that I say to all the girls that are willing to listen, because not everyone's willing to listen, mm-hmm. that you can go back, you can finish high school, or you can get your GED, you can go to college. No matter what may have happened in your life, you know, we've got girls that have come in that have been, you know, raped by their stepfather, sexual abuse.
Yes.
We've got girls who, you know, have been introduced to drugs by their parents. We've got girls who the city didn't seem to care whether or not they went to school. They may have gotten to report the issues that were going on in their home, but they were still left there. So regardless of the situation, come into our doors, because we're going to help you to navigate through. I'm going to be there to hug you, because we're huggers. I'm going to be there to hug you. I'll cry because it's emotional and gut-wrenching when you hear some of the challenges that some of the moms face in the community, in the homes, and that they remain invisible to the community, because it may be somebody that you've seen walking down the street, but you didn't realize that her stepfather was sleeping with her, or that her stepbrother touched her yesterday. You didn't realize that that's the reason that she isn't going to school, or that she doesn't have food in the home. And these are all things, you know, we hear the stories, but we help to move beyond that, beyond the pain, because that pain can be like quicksand, mm-hmm. and hold you down.
Continue to pull you down.
Yeah, and we're not going to let that pull you down. We're going to push you, sometimes, you know, to our detriment, because sometimes girls get mad, right?
Yes.
They get upset, but we're going to continue to push you, because it's not necessarily about me. It's about you and your future, and it's the same thing that I would want for my own daughter that I'm pushing you to do for yourself.
What a beacon of light. I mean, just to hear your passion, it says we're here for you. And I think you make a great point at a time now that the District of Columbia is reporting so many missing children. I mean, we see kids going coming, and we never wonder about the shoes they're walking in. Where are you located?
We're located in Ward 7, 4501 Grant Street Northeast, mm-hmm. and in a transitional home. So it's a transitional home.
So if anyone from any ward or any young person anywhere wanted to find you, do you take them from all wards?
We take them from all wards. They can come in anytime from 9 to
5.
I mean, we're open late on Mondays and Wednesday evenings, so they can come in, but we're doing classes. Mm-hmm. But we ask them to come in a little bit earlier so that we can sit down and really have time to talk to them, to explain what it is that we do, and to find out what their needs are when they walk in. I'm going to say that we don't necessarily believe that one size fits all, because
right.
I think that's a problem going
right.
on in the government as a whole. Everybody
Correct.
Wants these evidence-based models. And it's great to have evidence-based models that give you a guidance
yes.
on how to assist.
Yes.
But my shoe size is not your shoe size.
Absolutely.
And
not.
So there's no one size fits all formula that's
right.
going to help 100%. Yes, baby care basics is universal.
Yes.
Parenting may be universal, definitely. But there's other idiosyncrasies that with each family that you've got to make changes to. You know, and Jasmine goes out to the home. She can tell you about the importance of, you know, making changes in how she approaches each family.
Yeah, Jasmine, I also would like to, I'm so glad to hear you say that, because we all bring different things in our baggage when we go into any situation.
Yes.
And nothing is more critical than the baggage that one brings who's from a troubled background.
Yeah.
And in order to reach me, you've got to start out with who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And you're right, there is no one size fit all.
Yeah.
But Jasmine, first of all, I just heard her say you do outreach as well, going out to home.
Yes.
But how does a teen get into your system? What would they have to do if a teen saw this show today and says, I would love to go to Healthy Babies Project? Tell me how that whole process would happen.
So we do get a lot of our teams from referrals. So
referrals,
from
okay.
Different schools, the DCPS schools, our child family services, but we try to make it easy for them. So if a mom calls and they want the services, we say, just come in now. You don't have to make an appointment, just walk in. Or if that's, transportation is a barrier for you, then I'll just come to you. You know, when are you free? I'll meet you after school, or I'll meet you at school. Mm-hmm. Because we are aware that transportation is a barrier.
Correct.
And finances are barriers for some of these young moms to get to and fro. So we try to cut that out as much as possible. So we're very open, just come as you are.
And what kind of follow-up might one need? Now, I know in your services you mm-hmm. would transfer, or you do a transition of teen families into sort of a residential facility or something. Is that where you go, or do you actually go into a home where mm-hmm. a teen might be living with their biological or foster families?
Exactly. So we go into their home. So our larger program is case management.
Okay.
So that's when we work one-on-one with moms, mm-hmm. connecting them to resources, making sure they go back to school, talking about bonding and attachment, because regardless of what your background is, what you've been through, the relationship that you have with your baby is the most important thing. Mm-hmm. So we really work with them on trying to build that and build empathy. And that's more a trickle effect of them accomplishing the goals that they have set for themselves.
Okay.
So we do also have the transitional housing program for moms that are homeless. But we try to work with the ones that are with their families to stay with their families. That's your support system. Mm-hmm. And if they're gonna be there for you, to continue that.
Right.
So we do have a number of different programs, mm-hmm. But we go to the homes for the case management aspect.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And Ms. Harper, you are the proof of the pudding, or in the pudding.
Yes.
So you have had the opportunity to be a participant in, and you're still involved, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you share with the viewers what this has been like for you, what it has meant for you, and what your plans are right now, because I'm very proud to hear that.
Okay, well, I came to Healthy Babies Project in, I think, June or May 2015.
Okay.
I was 4 months pregnant, and I'm from the hood. I'm from D.C., Washington, D.C., Northeast.
Okay.
So I walked in there with a tank top on, 4 months pregnant, a tank top on, and booty shorts on.
Okay. Tank tops and booty shorts. Okay.
But when I first came to Healthy Babies, and I did my intake, and then I was introduced to the parents in class. I was going to parents in class weekly and everything like that. But as time went by and my daughter was born, and I realized that my living situation, it wasn't what I wanted for her, and it wasn't mm-hmm. what I wanted for myself. So that's when I came to Healthy Babies, and they accepted me into the transitional house, and I was living there since then. But just more than helping me with housing for my daughter, it's just been eye-opening. Like, I've been introduced to so many different opportunities, so many different people, so many different chances, like things that people aren't introduced to every day. People in my predicament, teen moms, anybody really, aren't introduced to. Like, they're not introduced to people that work at law firms. Like, I've had the ability to go and be a volunteer at a law firm, not a volunteer, intern at a law firm, and sit with people in the corporate business thing.
Oh, wow.
And be able to relate and be able to enunciate, articulate to people and talk to people, so that I'm not, like, they realize I'm not a statistic. And that's just the example I want to set for other moms that come into the program. Like,
you're
your own
you.
Person,
Kudos for you.
Your daughter or your son,
yes.
or whoever you have, it's not a barrier.
Oh, wow, what a powerful statement for not only you, but for your organization. And you said something that reinforces your mission and your goal. When she said when she saw her baby, she knew that she did not want that kind of life for herself anymore or for her baby.
Yes.
Rebirth, yes. A chance at new. And just talking with you before the show, I found out that you have just exactly what any young woman should have, and that's a plan. And your plan is to?
Well, since I got my GED after I dropped out of high school for 2 years straight, I wasn't in school, but I came healthy babies. They introduced me to a program. I got my GED in, I think, 5 months. I got my GED.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, I'm working different fields, everything like that, but I'm pretty sure I'm about to register for school to do either business or education.
That is such a wonderful, wonderful feat. And you've been able to watch her grow. What kind of pride do you guys feel just seeing her? I mean, I haven't worked with her that long, and I just want to stick my chest out. I mean, this must be good.
I think even sometimes I feel like she's selling herself short because, mm-hmm. yes. you know, when Nadira came in, she had so much personality. She still has a lot of personality mm-hmm. now.
She does.
But,
she does.
You know, the way that she came in and got things done for herself and for her baby was something that we hadn't seen in a long time. And coming in and finishing school and, you know, knocking grades down, Oof. She's very intelligent.
Mm.
And so just to see her grow into a young lady, being able to carry herself and just the sense of pride that she has within herself and the relationship that she has with her child is something that you don't see every day. So we're very proud of her.
Oh, wow. I really feel good for you. And I feel good for healthy babies and hope that you are around wherever you are on that corner in the middle of that block for a long time. But I do know the challenges of nonprofits. So you mentioned some of them. Are there any costs associated with helping young women when you bring them in?
Well, all the services are free to the moms, so they're
okay.
able to
all
come into the program
okay.
at no cost to them. To reside in the house, it's at no cost to them.
Okay.
It definitely requires constantly going after resources in the forms of funding and
yes.
you know, donors to donate simple things, from definitely the finances to be able to pay the free, you know, for the property, gas, water, electricity. But simple things that people don't think that they can donate, from toilet paper to Bounty towels to cleaning products, even a mop or the wet part of the, I don't know what you call it, but the mopping stick.
Sweeper.
But all of those basic things. But I do want to go back to one thing with Nadira. It's not a choice for your education. It's an absolute. It's a definitive.
That's true.
So, you know, she is going to school because it's not an option.
and
she knows how. She knows, because I say it all the time. Okay, you know, it's going to happen because it's a change for your family.
Absolutely.
It's a change for your family, and that's going to trickle down to Natalia, mm-hmm. you know, as well. And, you know, we know, like, Natalia's going to be a plastic surgeon, you know, and so I know that she won't be able to do my tummy tuck in the future, She's on the road. She's going to be a plastic surgeon.
Well, you know what? You sound like the mom of the house.
She is.
I love the way you just did that. It is not, it's not an option. You are going to college. I love that. So I can imagine all the children that you have running around in the city,
mm-hmm.
both the children and the grandchildren running
yes.
around in the city.
Yes.
So that speaks to the love and the commitment and the passion that you all have. And you just answered one question that I was going to ask you directly. If viewers wanted to know how they could help you, how could they help? Now, you just started out by anything from paper towels to viewers, anything, cleaning products, baby diapers, anything. But I want you to give some closing kind of remarks, as well as you, about any other things that you think that the viewers should know about your wonderful service. Because I'm sincere, we need more nonprofits for our children like you. Are providing for them. I mean, they're running away, they're getting lost, they're disappearing. They need to know somebody is there for them. So speak to our viewers and to our children.
Can I speak on that real quick?
Yes.
For anyone, teenage mom, runaway, people that need help, everything like that, the support that Healthy Babies provides to people is crucial in everyday lives. It's crucial in people growing up and trying to find themselves and things like that, because a lot of times when you get pregnant, 15, 14, 16, you feel alone. Like, you feel like people can't relate to you. No one understands, you know. A lot of times you do feel like your life is over. Like, I have to take care of a child now. You know, I don't put myself first, everything like that. And then, like, me personally, when I came to Healthy Babies, you know, me and my mother's relationship's always been rocky. So I needed that support, and I needed that push, and I needed that example, someone to look to, someone that I want to be like, someone that was like, helps me personally, you know, build that emotional connection, just to make me want to push harder for myself.
Thank you so much for that. Thank you so much for that. And they should believe you, and I hope they emulate you.
I will say that to your viewers, you know, that it's the support that they can give is definitely coming in and understanding more of the services they hand on.
Yes.
But then they're the donors out there, they're the builders, because the city is being rebuilt.
Yes.
That keep in mind the fact that we've got these young girls that are homeless. We've got these young boys that are homeless, the fathers of the babies as well,
yes,
that are struggling, and that are struggling and making changes in their lives.
Yes.
And as they're building these new amazing facilities, keep in mind that these young ladies need a place to live.
Yes.
They need permanency.
Yes.
And so, you know, I will gladly take a call from one of these builders that says, hey, I'm going to build you a facility that these young moms can be able to go and move into permanently, where they can actually buy. Because we know that by ownership is what gives us permanency.
Yes.
So this would be their residence where they can live for the rest of their lives,
mm-hmm,
and thrive,
mm-hmm,
and be, you know, viable citizens for the District of Columbia, for the United States.
Yes.
We want our moms to be educated, but in order for them to get that education, they need that support and they need that permanency. And so I challenge the viewers, I challenge the mayors, I challenge the construction folks that are out there to give me a call at Healthy Babies, 202-396-2809. Ask for Regina Ellie. You know, give me a call and let's sit down, and I will gladly sit with you and map out a plan to establish permanency for these moms. Be the person who makes that mark in the district and makes a difference. We rise by lifting others.
Yes.
That's my message to the,
yes,
to your viewers. We rise by lifting others. So,
and I want you to just close by saying one very special service that you talked about. If somebody wanted to volunteer, mm-hmm, just to provide care for,
yes,
for the
so we definitely, you know, to the viewers, we always need child care, and it's more than that. We need someone to be mentors, to really care for the children that we have there, and even mentors for our mothers, to stay with them, to really be that mentor that they need. We have a number of programs that we would love volunteers to come and participate. We have a doula program where we're inviting the community to be an extra step of support to these young moms during labor and delivery,
mm-hmm,
and a mentor for these fathers. They need examples,
yes,
and they really do want them.
Yes.
But I think us as a society has lost hope in them.
Yes.
So I would just ask viewers to just come in. There's so many programs that we need assistance with. And definitely the children, so that the mothers can participate in these programs, can go to interviews,
yes,
can go to school,
yes,
those things.
I think that's just so amazing. I mean, if there's any show that I've done before where my heart is just leaping and beating so fast and I'm saying, I wish I could hit the lottery. I'll take care of these girls for you. Don't you worry about a thing. Oh, I tell you, this has been so heartwarming. I also want to share with the viewers that in 2011, Healthy Babies Project Incorporated did receive a wonderful award from the D.C. Council, and it was at the time that the D.C. Council had approved the D.C. Child Abuse Recognition Resolution. So as early as that, your wonderful work has continued to go forward. And I know what a hard time that nonprofits are having now. I mean, and who knows about this new administration, what's going to happen.
Yes.
But we've got to keep fighting for our children. We've got to keep fighting for our children. And so The transition house as well, where the teen moms and families are going now. Anything, vacuum cleaners, ironing boards, anything. And we're asking new things, things that they can use.
Yes.
My own personal feeling is they've had enough beat up stuff in
exactly.
their lives already.
Yes.
And they're babies. They take baby, you know,
baby
clothes.
Babies.
And when they said to me, gently used, I said, no. We have new people in the world. We want them to start out with new clothing. So anything from little onesies and everything, I really throw my heart out to our viewers to contact you and to find out how they can be of service. And my hat goes out to you for your love and for your compassion. And my hat goes out to you for all the hard work that you're doing, the outreach, and the confidence that you have in her.
Yes.
And to you, I'm looking for great things.
That's right.
And I'm going to hook you up with the recruiter here at the University of the District of Columbia, because I would like for us to be a part of this positivity in your life as well.
Thank you.
Okay?
Yay, I'm so excited.
Oh, wow. I feel good, and I feel scared, and I feel energized, because I really am. I'm serious when I say I want your light to continue to shine there in Northeast, wherever you are. Ms.
Mm-hmm.
Ellie,
yes.
Ms. Harper, and Ms. Brazier.
Yes.
Thank you all for being here with me on Health Matters today. If you viewers want more information about Healthy Babies Project INC, you may visit, no, I'm gonna say please visit their website at www.healthybabiesproject.org. And if you'd like more information about the Department of Nursing and Allied Health at the University of the District of Columbia, please visit our website at www.udc.edu/nursing. I'm Dr. Connie Webster. Thank you for watching. Please join me next time. And remember, your health matters. More importantly, your baby's health matters.